I've been waiting to do this one for a while. I've got it in a trade. Oh, brother, I got this wax business. Got it in a trade, and it's a, you know, American wild ale. Good Lord, I probably shouldn't have been filming this, huh? And, yeah, it's supposed to be somewhat sour-ish. What a mess. Give it a try now. Oh, come on, baby! Ooh, somewhere. Lordy! Houses are rocking. Don't bother knocking. You can see the carnage, the wax. Had some trouble. Alright, here we go. Yeah, I've been waiting for this one for a while. I'm hoping it's going to be pretty good. I traded for it with somebody out in the Pacific Northwest because we can't get this Deschutes around here. It's gets good reviews. Looking forward to it. Take a picture here and give it a taste. I thought I would do my very first aroma and tasting on camera just for fun. It does have maybe a lacto kind of aroma, that lambic-ish, or maybe more like a Flanders red or sour brown. And it has that taste. It does remind me of La Folie, actually. Maybe not as sour and potent as I remember La Folie being, but the last time I had La Folie, I didn't think it was quite as strong as I remembered it, and actually this is more like that. It's man, I don't know what it goes for, $10 a bottle or something, but it's some good stuff, and I hope more breweries will keep making this kind of stuff. It says it's a Flanders style brown, so actually I kind of forgot about that, so that does make sense that it's more like that instead of like a, you know, super puckering goose or something. Cheers.